Renewable energy, the topic at the Thomas Crane Public Library on Wednesday, November 18th from 7 to 8:30 with Harvard physicist Dr. Mara Prentiss making a presentation. But you're lucky because she's here right now to give us a little preview. Doctor, welcome.
Hello, it's great to be here.
Interesting to talk to you about this particular topic. This is a program co-sponsored with the folks at QCAN, Quincy Climate Action Network.
Yes, absolutely. That I had an opportunity to meet them earlier when I was doing a talk in Arlington. Mm-hmm. And I'm very impressed with the work that they're doing.
Okay.
That we're living in a time of tremendous change. The revolution is coming whether we want it or not.
How did you become drawn to this particular topic?
I actually got frustrated with misinformation. So many people I talked to said, well, I heard blah, 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 that, you know, we have enough solar energy on the roof of Walmart to power the entire United States. Like, well, who told you that? Like, well, I saw that here on the internet.
It's okay.
Like, well, where did that calculation come from? It came from the internet. It's like, okay. And I discovered that a huge amount of dialogue that people have with each other about energy reduced to, I read it somewhere and I have absolutely no idea.
So a light bulb went off saying, I need to get
yes.
the real information out there.
So I made an effort to make a simple series of calculations that anybody can check.
Okay.
That if I made a mistake, people will find out and tell me.
Oh, all right.
And that they can go through and say, okay, well, I'm not sure I like that assumption. Okay, change it and then see what your number comes out to be.
Mm-hmm.
And I really want to give people an opportunity to make decisions for themselves.
Mm.
That I didn't want to advocate any particular position, but to say, here's a way of looking at what's possible.
So you've written an actual book on this topic?
I have written a book that
okay.
has come out in February.
Okay.
And it goes through the basic ideas. The talk is more highlights and a case for what is possible. We're in a time of huge transition. Last year, the solar power that comes from houses surpassed commercial solar power for the first time.
Mm.
And it's just taking off tremendously. According to Bloomberg, it's going to be cheaper than the grid in 36 states next year.
Just in 1 year?
In 1 year.
Really?
So it's a huge change in the economics of renewable energy.
Okay.
And I think that many people aren't aware of how much change there's been recently.
Mm.
You know, people remember, oh, in 1990, blah, 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 or even, you know, 2010,
mm-hmm.
that the transitions have been enormous. So I'm partly taking an opportunity to say that we're living in a new and different world, and it gives us huge opportunities.
Is the United States kind of behind the eight ball when it comes to renewable energy as compared to other countries?
It's very variable. Some states like Iowa on some months generate more than half of their electricity from wind.
Wow. Okay.
And on average, something more than 25%. So it varies tremendously from place.
I see.
And the numbers are increasing enormously. You know, you look at a graph and it's flat, flat, flat. And then wind and solar have been taking off tremendously.
Hmm.
And it's a shift all over the world. In Denmark last year, there was a moment where Denmark generated more electricity from wind than the entire country
wow.
consumes.
Oh, really?
And in Germany, there was a sunny summer day where solar generated more energy than all other sources combined. Coal, nuclear,
mm-hmm.
gas,
mm-hmm.
everything generated less than solar on that day.
Okay. Well, I know in some of the countries, particularly Germany, the government actually requires a certain percentage of energy to be quote-unquote renewable.
That they do.
Yeah.
They have a very complex energy policy, which they're greatly debating.
Right.
And they're trying to decide how to make shifts.
Right. And would it work here, do you think, is a question.
Well, the nice thing is that it's not only a government question now, it's a question for individuals.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
This growth of rooftop solar means it's not an issue for Congress so much anymore, and that individual people can look at it.
Yeah, we had the Solarize Quincy initiative right here in Quincy. Several hundred people signed up, and they're having solar systems installed in their homes. Yeah.
I was impressed on my way. I saw this house that was covered with solar panels. Like, wow, they have really gone for it.
Right.
And the idea is that in Massachusetts, I believe in about 4 years, you now start to make money off your system.
Hmm.
So it's a huge shift. And that's part of the revolution. It's not buying from central sources anymore.
Mm.
People are now having an opportunity to make their own choices.
What do the utility companies think about all that?
Well, it's a big change, and I think that it's a revolution for them, too. That it's like becoming middle-aged, as we were discussing.
Right.
It's not so much choice. it's happening to you anyway.
Right.
And the question is how to either manage it gracefully or embrace it, depending on how you'd like to look at it.
Yeah.
And I think that's what the power companies are being faced with.
Well, it's a timely topic with the news just recently of the Pilgrim nuclear plant imminently shutting down in the next 4 or 5 years or so. So it's become a hot topic of conversation at the state level, too. What will your talk here at the library entail?
It's basically a brief overview of how we can make changes to basically eliminate burning fossil fuels. Mm. And there are a huge number of things that turn out to be easier than you would think. For example, there's a basic science law that says half of the energy that you put into an engine is lost.
A gasoline engine?
A gasoline engine.
Okay.
And the actual numbers are worse. Mm. That's the ideal case. Okay. Real gas engines are only about 15% for a car efficient in the city. It's terrible.
Wow.
And if you just convert to electricity for that, you don't take that loss. So the amount of renewable energy you need is less than half of what we extract in fossil fuels. So a lot of my message is, it's a lot easier than you might have thought.
Mm.
There are a huge number of little things which make a big difference. And a factor of two is enormous. And so I try to offer possibilities, again, for people to think about.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not trying to tell anyone what to do.
Okay.
I'm saying, these are possibilities you might consider
to
see what ones are of importance to you.
Here are the facts. Make your choice.
Yes, exactly.
So have you made that choice in your personal life?
Parts of it I have made, and parts not yet.
Okay.
That the thing about solar panels is they're an investment,
mm-hmm.
and my daughter just started college.
So which is also an investment.
Which is an investment, and maybe want to move to a smaller house,
and
should we downsize, and so it's a time of transition, so a capital investment may not be quite the right thing.
Okay.
But that's part of it, is looking at where one is in their individual lives. On the other hand, I've gone for all the smart thermostats and the LED lights, and I walk back and forth to work every day and don't take the car.
Yeah.
So I think everyone has a different mix of things that are right for them.
Yeah.
And that one of the worst problems with the environmental movement has been a sort of a hair shirt. Well, I'm willing to freeze at minus 30 in my apartment and sleep in a parka, and I can use less power that way. And people okay.
Or you could insulate better.
Yes.
Right.
And that having people become martyrs is exciting for some, but not, I think, a good overall strategy.
Okay.
So I'm trying to say you can actually be more comfortable and happier and use less energy.
Okay. So your goal is to get correct information and let people make their own choices.
Exactly.
Yeah. Sounds interesting. Sounds fascinating.
Well, I am hopeful that people will enjoy it.
Yeah. Again, it is Wednesday, November 18th, 7 to 8:30 at the main branch of the Thomas Crane Library. Doctor, thank you so much for stopping by. I appreciate
it. Thank you very much. Have a good afternoon.
You're welcome. You as well. And if you'd like to get more information about this or any programs at the library, just visit their website. It's thomascranelibrary.org.